أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We begin today with a question that we get a lot is what are the best books for street dawah? I'm not talking about scholarly works and refutation of other religions and things. Then you can go to the works of the earlier scholars. But I'm talking about dawah at dawah tables and street fairs, on the ground, at universities, and being involved in that for the last 20 something years. I want to share some books that I found very beneficial. Tayyib, and I'm going to focus this to a Western audience, meaning that the da'wah that's going on in Europe, in the United States, in America, Canada, maybe South America, and maybe in other countries like China, you may have different fields, but in the Western countries, mostly you have two audiences you're going to be debating with. One is atheists, and second is Christians. So let's take on what books are necessary. This is the part of the library that has books of misguided sects and different religions and refutations that I use for da'wah, and mostly street da'wah. Tayyib, so let's start with Christians. With Christians, the first thing I suggest is that you get different versions of the Bible. Get a Catholic Bible, get a Protestant Bible, and in a Protestant Bible, you should get different translations because it's not like there's just different words. They're actually different chapters. The Catholic Bible has books in it, entire chapters, books that are not there in the Christian Bible. So then you have to challenge Christians and say, which one is the message of Isa alayhi salam? How many books should be in the Old Testament? How many chapters are in the New Testament? And you will find discrepancies between them. And within that, I suggest you get a couple of different Bibles from the Christian Bibles with different translations. And I have these. This is a King James Standard Version, and this is the standard to be used. And then I also have a New World Translation. This is the one that's usually used by Jehovah's Witnesses. I also have the Book of Mormon. And you need to have this and show Christians, hey, where is this in your Bible? Where did this come from? Because Muslims, alhamdulillah, we have one Quran. No matter what sect, what fiqh you follow, and so you have one Quran. Starts with Al-Fatiha, end with Nas, 30 ajza across the board. You can go to China, you can go anywhere. Even misguided sects, you always go back to that one Quran based on the Mus'haf of Uthman radiyallahu anhu. Alhamdulillah, Allah preserved that for us. But here you have the Mormons with an entire different book that you will not find in the Christian Bible. If you take the Christian Bible and you look at the New World Translation, and the regular King James translation, they have many clear differences. I'm going to point one out for you here, inshallah ta'ala, which you will find in Luke. This is the New Testament. Luke chapter 9, verse 56. This is the King James version. For the Son of Man did not come to destroy men's lives, but to save them. This is Luke chapter 9, verse 56, King James version. Now, the same Protestant Bible, but the New World Translation, you go to the same chapter, Luke chapter 9, verse 56. It says, so they went to a different village. What? So they went to a different village. What happened to the Son of Man coming to save and destroy? You see, this isn't a different translation, different means of recitation or a word. This is totally different. And this is between the Christian Bibles. So I suggest you get some of these so that you can point these out in your da'wah. And there's a lot of other contradictions and so on. You can see my Bibles are marked up. Now, I'm going to suggest also a book called The Dead Sea Scrolls. And these are the earliest Bible manuscripts and what was based on that. And you will find many differences between them and what we have published today as Christian Bibles. So you should know the Dead Sea Scrolls and the differences so you can use that for your da'wah. And even these don't go back to the time of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Tayyib, regarding Christians, I'm going to mention a couple of other books really quickly. This is a classic. This is an OG book, Ahmed Didad from back in the days, The Choice. I got this back in the 90s and I've been using this for da'wah since then. It's amazing. There is a book called The Hidden Message in the Bible, Dr. Ammar Haloon. I don't know him personally, but I've had this book and I've read through it and I found many interesting verses in it. There is also The Prophet Muhammad SAW in the Bible by Qais al-Kilbi and What Did Jesus Really Say by Mish'al ibn Abdullah. All good books, but these are focused towards Christians. Now you have a lot of atheists that are going to hit you up. So for atheists, I'm going to suggest a couple of books. One book, and to me this is a must have, If you're going to be giving da'wah to atheists, this is a great book. Dr. Mustafa Mahmoud, it's called Dialogue with an Atheist. I really love this book because Dr. Mustafa goes into actual conversations that he's had, and it's a question answer back and forth. And it really did benefit me in talking to atheists and kind of looking at some of the ways that they try to attack us. Secondly, there is a book, and this is written by a sheikh, a sheikh Abdul Latif Al-Khayyat, and he has a book, A Refutation of Doubts About Current Issues, Application of Sharia, Inheritance, Hudud, Punishments, Jihad, Slavery in Islam, Polygamy, the Murtad, Talaq, Equality. So these are a lot of issues that we face. And this is originally written by Sheikh Salih Abdullah ibn Humaid. And he's one of the imma in Mecca. I had the pleasure to sit with him last time, another time before when I went to Mecca. Sheikh Abdul Latif Al-Khayyat, he's the one that translated into English and published it. Al-Manara Publications is the one that I have it from. And it's very brief, but it tackles a lot of issues that people want to always debate with you about. Tayyib. The last book I'm going to recommend here, and this is a book by a non-Muslim author, Stephen C. Meyer, and he, I don't know if he's Christian or what, but he has done an excellent job of looking at a lot of Darwin's theories and showing the mistakes and the gaps in the theory of evolution regarding humans coming from apes. This book that I have is called Darwin's Doubt. I read through it on a plane trip and really, really benefited from it. And I've used it a lot in giving da'wah to the people who have made atheism into a religion and blindly follow Darwinism. So I'm going to suggest these books. There are a lot of other books, but inshallah, I'm going to stop here and hope that this will be a benefit for those that are involved in street da'wah. The last point to make, in street da'wah, don't let the da'wah go to philosophy and their rules. You have to keep the da'wah on the rules of the Quran. So the number one book you need for street da'wah is the Quran, and understanding of the Quran, and about the miracles of the Quran. And when you know that, about the miracles of Prophet ﷺ, about the importance of Islam and Tawheed, then that should be your number one tool. These books are only to clear up people's minds. But if you prove the Bible to be wrong, if you prove Darwin to be wrong, but then you can't close the deal by showing them the truth of Islam, you didn't win this debate. You didn't win. Your point is always to call people to Islam, to Tawheed. So in the end, the Book of Allah, knowing the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, knowing Islam well, and having that knowledge is the most essential tool in da'wah. Wa jazakum Allahu khairan.